Hi guys, welcome to another video. Since 2021, DJI Enterprise have been introducing their LiDAR solutions. And then this year, DJI Enterprise have been introduced the new update from the previous Zenmuse L1. We have here in the office Zenmuse L2. So here we have a side-by-side between the Zenmuse L1 and the Zenmuse L2. So if you take a look from the outside itself, the Zenmuse L2, in terms of the size, a bit bigger compared to the Zenmuse L1 due to the improved the LiDAR module and also the camera for the visual. Speaking of the compatibility, the Zenmuse L1 can be paired with the Matrix 200RTK and also the Matrix 350RTK. And about the Zenmuse L2, it also can be paired with the Matrix 200RTK, but using the RC Plus remote controller, also compatible with the Matrix 250RTK. So make sure you up to date, check the firmware versions and update your current Matrix 250RTK or Matrix 300RTK to be compatible with both Zenmuse LiDAR payload. So let's take a look and dive in into the features being upgraded compared to the Zenmuse L1s. So we have a long list here I would like to cover on. So let's go one by one. So the first one is the improved LiDAR module, where now it emits much smaller size of laser. It can enhance the penetrations of the laser through the vegetation itself, and it can detect much smaller object on the ground, much more details on the ground itself. Now the Zenmuse L2 support 5 return mode compared to the previous one, only 3 returns. Where with this 5 returns, it can penetrate. Okay, the laser will first bounce from the top of the tree, and then throughout the return mode, it will saturate the shape of the tree itself, the height, and then the last point will be the ground itself, where we can easily categorize it and classify it, any features above the ground and the ground itself, so we can get more detailed and more accurate VEM generation. On top of that, for the point cloud data rates, Zenmuse L2 can support until 1.2 million points per second, compared to the Zenmuse L1, only 480,000 points per second. So with that, we can see more point cloud on the ground itself. In terms of the visual camera, they also been improved, where previously they're using 1-inch. Now update much bigger sensor size, which is the 4/3 CMOS sensor, can cover much bigger coverage for the photogrammetry. And then the second one, we use it to utilize colorizing it on your point cloud data sets. Not only that, since we have the two different sensor, LiDAR and also the visual camera, we can view it in the remote controller during the acquisitions side by side, where we can take a look on the real-time LiDAR point cloud and also the real-time RGB camera being captured. So to the next point, I would like to cover related to the efficiency. This one, I would say a great deal also in terms of the efficiency, where the previously on the Zenmuse L1, we have to wait 5 minutes for the payload to be warming up. Now with the Zenmuse L2, you don't have to wait 5 minutes. You install it, make sure you check all your missions, and straight away you can deploy your drones. The Zenmuse L2 also offers the quality report, where once you have done your missions, you will pop up a report, so the pilot can view what are the quality. The pilot have the kind of an insight of informations about their acquisitions, so you can do more decision making. So covering on the processing side, with any purchase of the Zenmuse L2, it comes with the support of the point cloud processing inside the DJI Terra. So inside the DJI Terra, we can benefit a lot of features we can process on. First one is the true color point cloud in a last file, the height, the reflectivity, the return mode, and also the ground classifications inside the DJI Terra. And on top of that, with the ground classification, we can generate the digital elevation modeling inside the Terra itself. Also, we can check in terms of the accuracy, where we can import all the ground control point or the any checkpoint we have done on the site to the DJI Terra and cross check or double check into the accuracy result being generated. We have covered in the box and also the function and features being upgraded compared to the Zenmuse L1s. On top of that, we also have done the case study. We compared the data quality from the L1 and also the L2, how the penetration into the quality of the data itself. So do follow us to get know more about the case study. If you have any question about the Zenmuse L2, if you are interested, please do reach us out. See you on the next video and thank you for watching. Bye-bye. Thank you.